20 minutes is up. Just let you guys see that I'm not messing around with this HIIT cardio. Very sweaty. Just 20 minutes. 45 seconds moderate, 15 seconds all out blasting. I'm absolutely drenched, even more so than my hour on the step mill, or at least equal to, because that's also a pain in the ass too, an hour on the step mill, but that's how we're doing it right now. All right, day two of recording. First meal of the day, 2 p.m. Just died down my HIIT 20 minutes cardio. So I'm just pulled out some food that I just felt like eating right now. So I'm gonna experiment and do a can of sardines. I'm gonna utilize this expensive ass chipotle lime avocado oil mayo, which is truly avocado oil and not cut with soybean oil and all this other crap like these cheaper versions. You'll see like a olive oil mayonnaise. Well, don't get fooled because it's usually cut with cheaper canola oil or soy oil first, or soybean oil. And then, so I'm gonna throw the sardines here. I'm gonna chop it up. I'm gonna add the mayo as I see fit, whether it's 1 or 2 tablespoons. Add a little dollop of Dijon, chop up some nice fresh pickles from the Pickled Pantry, which is a homemade pickles from a guy that does it himself. We really like his products. We gotta add some of his sauerkraut in there too, some fermented sauerkraut cabbage, and some broccoli sprouts, of course, for the health benefits. Mash this up, and if I add tablespoons of nut butter or anything else, I will record that for you guys and let you know what meal. All right, here's everything mixed in, the sardines, sprouts, new avocado mayo, the fermented pickles, fermented sauerkraut. I'm gonna add a half chicken sausage and a little cube of cheese. I'm gonna measure all this out, crunch the numbers. That is meal one, and there it is. Cute meal too. What cute meal do you, is this your first meal of the day too?
Yeah.
Her meal is little, those are grass-fed, high-quality, organic little smokies. They're all beef, yeah?
Yep.
And then 2 fried eggs and delicious butter. That's Rachel's meal. All right, guys, this meal is meal 2. It's coming really fast. I wasn't going to eat this early, but we're leaving right now because I have to go pick up some grass-fed beef that's 20-plus miles away. We're going to bring you guys along with that, too. So real fast, I'm going to have a thing of smoked clams in olive oil, 10 grams of fat, 16 grams of protein, and I'm probably going to scoop out, like, 2 tablespoons of this coconut butter. Remember, this is the butter, not the oil, so it has trace amino acids, which, you know, come from the protein and, of course, fiber, etc., and the MCT fats as well. So that's real quick. I have that now because I don't know when my next meal will be, and I don't want to go be too starved before my workout, because once we're out there picking up the grass-fed beef, we're also going to go find a gym out there and train. So I'm going to record all this stuff and put it down for you guys and let you know at the end of the day. All right, we've arrived. We're picking up my grass-fed beef that I ordered online. They shipped it from Utah, and now they're in like a little truck or trailer.
That's weird.
And we're picking it up right now. Rachel's a little skeptical, but we'll see how good the quality is. I'm gonna go. Let's do it. I don't think I need them. I already paid them, so. This is the meat pickup from Utah. So 10 pounds of grass-fed beef, and it's said to be, can't really see the leanness, but it's about 12% fat, and it's 100% grass-fed, grass-finished. So we picked that up. They come every 2 months, and we met them in a parking lot. They drove all the way up from Utah. And now we're at a meat market right now at a butcher, and I'm gonna go see if I can grab some more quality meats or game meats. So see what we get. Ribeye burgers. Filet. Last time we got the marinated tri-tip. Let's see what we get this time. Do you want to get marinated tri-tip again? Did you ever have that where I slice it real thin? Like Uncle David style? We have exotic meats over here in the freezer, which I'm actually stocked up on. But there's wild boar patties there. And I think elk and venison as well. And then, so it's back day, and every back training day I do body weight pull-ups. We start our workout with that. My lats, I've always lagged. I've always had decent thickness, but my lat width is just not that good. So this is what we're doing. Hopefully eventually I'll be able to build up and add dumbbells or weight to my feet. But right now I'm just doing body weight.
Alright guys, it's 8:30 p.m. We just got done training back, as you just saw, and haven't eaten since that little snack at like 2 p.m. It's 8 p.m. or 8:30, it's been a while. So we're gonna have some post-workout breakfast or dinner at Sammy's. So we're gonna see what we can get here. Just randomly eating, just as is. So we'll record, I'll record it on my phone, then I'll try to crunch the numbers to get the calorie totals, etc. So here we go.
Ahi pokey, no carbs, hard to see. And the entrees are coming. All right, here we go. Rachel got the double patty Kobe beef burger with lettuce wraps, or lettuce, what, pads?
Sure.
And I got the gigantic chicken Greek salad with feta cheese and
ranch
because the balsamic had sugar. Endless diet sodas. And we're gonna give this a go. And this is meal three, and it's 9:30. Last meal of the night. Did our restaurant meal earlier around 9 o'clock. It's almost 12. And we're gonna finish it off with 3.4 ounces of the grass-fed sirloin, 1.5 ounce of a beef jerky from a butcher shop, a little piece, broccoli sprouts, spinach with my turmeric and ginger powder over there for digestion, and then whatever's in there of the coconut butter, which only looks like maybe 1.5 to 2 tablespoons maybe. So I'll record all these and crunch the numbers and get today's recording. So it looks like today will be, or tonight, we'll end off with 4 meals total, just like yesterday. And we will see what the values equate to. So this meal is actually a little higher in protein with the 3.5 ounce plus 1.5 ounce. So this might be, you know, not so ketogenic or anti-ketogenic, but I don't really care. I'm just, like I said, eating instinctively and not putting too much thought into it. So there it is.
All right guys, so I got the recording done for my day two of eating. So my meals that you saw yesterday. And of course, at the middle of the night, I did have another meal. So I think that maybe be meal five. And I had 1 ounce of raw walnuts. I had a half chicken sausage. I had 1.5 ounces of beef jerky again, and 1/4 cup of macadamia nuts. And so my meal totals for the day two recording are 155 grams of protein, 194 grams of fat, 31 grams of carbs, 18 grams fiber, net carbs 13. So really, just crunching these without even trying to meet a similar calorie load or macronutrient load, it was very similar to day one. So day one was 123 grams of protein, 200 grams of fat, 31 grams of carbs. So I mean, it's all kind of similar from these last 2 days. Today is actually, we're gonna refeed. So we're gonna do a carbohydrate refeed this weekend, and I'm not really gonna record that because who knows what the hell I'm gonna eat, if it's gonna be a full out cheat, like fattening cheat, or if it's gonna be a low fat sushi refeed or whatnot. So, but we'll obviously record that and bring you along for that. So I will record another day of eating, maybe post refeed tomorrow or sometime else during the week. And we'll get an average, but right now it's looking kind of similar to about 150 grams of protein, give or take, 200 grams of fat, give or take, and minimal carbs. All right guys, it's Saturday. And me and Rachel are gonna have a cheat meal tonight. Lately what I've been doing is I've been doing a little higher volume before our cheat meal or our carb load, whether it's a depletion workout, full body, what have you. Just to really, not that I need to, because I'm already probably so damn depleted just from no carbs and then working out really hard, hit cardio steady state. But I really like to do everything I can to feel justified in my cheat meal. I know it's stupid, or maybe there's some implications and merit to what I'm doing, is increasing enzymes and certain things in my muscle tissue to absorb the carbs even better. Maybe it's not necessary, but anyway, her legs are out of commission. She just had some surgery on her veins, so she can't do legs. So I'm actually gonna do legs in my garage here with my yoke bar. It's like 4 p.m. I've only eaten one meal, and then I'm gonna go with her tonight and work upper body before our cheat meal, and I'll probably do some arms. So yeah, you probably might wanna call it overtraining. That's what people would call it, with me not eating that much food and me training twice. I call it having fun, because I just love training. And obviously my body's not catabolic, because you guys have seen my body composition results. My weight stays at 240, so something's gelling and clicking on this low calorie content. So I'm gonna get my leg workout started here. I don't have much to work with. I have, you know, this old school leg extensions, kind of ghetto. And I have my squat, but all you need is a squat bar, right? I got a yoke bar and a regular squat bar back there. And I got my Corrupt playing on my MacBook. So we're gonna get down, do my legs. I don't know if I'm gonna train them too hard because I do gotta do arms tonight. And we'll take it from there. All right, guys, so that was a wrap. Obviously, I didn't film the warm-ups and the ascending sets to the heavier ones, but I did yoke bar squats, which for me is harder. Maybe I'm just not used to them, but I feel it's more like a front squat from the gravity plane and where it puts the weight on your frontal quads. So I do that first, and then I did the standard barbell squat afterwards. I felt a little weirdness in my right knee, so I stopped the barbell squats because I was gonna do a burnout set. And then I went to my little jimmy-rigged, my little bench leg extensions, and did four plates for a couple sets and then burned out. And that's it, because I know I got to do arms tonight before our little reload cheat meal. And that's it. You know, I didn't want to go. It's only been like 40 minutes. But I mean, my glutes, my hamstrings, you know, from the squats, everything got a really good stimulation. Everyone notices that I do box squats. I hurt my knee, my patellar tendon, minor tear a long time ago. I get chronic inflammation if I go below parallel. I love going ass to grass, I always did, but if you notice me using a bench or a box squat, it's not because I'm a vagina, it's because I used to actually always love going slow as possible. I just know every time that I've tried to do that, same shit, just a different day, it happens again and it ignites my inflammation and I'm back to square one. So yeah, I always do use a bench or something, but I'm just thankful that I can actually squat and stimulate my quads, because during my contest years, I wasn't able to squat and I was still able to do well at shows. And it's like now that I'm not competing, it's the irony is that I can squat now. So I'm really just enjoying squats even though it's with a bench. So. training. Just got done with training arms. As you saw earlier, I trained legs at the house here. We're gonna cheat or refeed. It's really Rachel's choice. I'm really content with just literally sticking to my damn diet because it's just so delicious with all the fats. So I'm gonna have another serving of farm grade, because remember I had one meal this morning. I went and trained legs in my house. Then I had another meal, and then I trained arms. So I've only had two meals today. I'm not really recording it today just because we're having a cheat, so it's kind of all over the place. But you can punch in farm grade at any time. Like anyone knows, in my write-up, you can amino pulse. You can kind of use farm grade intermittently, infrequently throughout the day, or frequently throughout the day. Really any time, it's versatile. Pre-workout, intra-workout, post-workout. I got my prototype post-workout formula that I'm gonna use right now with the farm grade. This stuff, man, 10 grams of, I can't say anything, but it has all proven clinical doses, just as you guys know. I say it all the time, but you guys know my formulas, I put a lot of heart into it, and I don't go the cheap route. I put my money where my mouth is, and I stand by my word, so everything we put out is top notch. So I'm gonna do a serving of this now because I'm still just taste testing things and making sure I agree with the formula. And this is what it's gonna look like. So it's a 2-scoop serving. There's one scoop. Shaboom. And the next scoop. So that right there is an entire serving of mega potent ingredients. And I'm gonna plug in my farm grade too. And that's it. So I'm also gonna snack on a little jerky too. Like I said, this is a cheat night or whatever. I'm not gonna be too, I'm kind of more lenient where I'm having more protein as far as the beef jerky without the excess of fat or whatever. So I'm not too concerned about being meticulous with my high fat to stay in ketosis on a cheat day. And it's kind of funny because I have a really good pump for being completely in a caloric deficit, because you know I am, because I did an hour of cardio this morning, okay? Then I had a meal that probably didn't even get me out of my hour of cardio as far as the calories. I probably burned 600 calories, I probably ate a 500 calorie meal. Then I went and trained legs pretty hard with squats, probably dug me in the hole again. Then I had another calorie, or maybe 400 calorie, 500 calorie meal. Then I trained arms, but I'm still maintaining fullness and all this stuff, so it's kind of awesome. How diet and hormones can really dictate everything, as far as they can kind of defy the laws of thermodynamics. It really is about nutrient timing and the right nutrients at the right time, and also having your body's hormonal balance in perfect harmony to work in order with the nutrition. So everything kind of comes together where you can kind of do amazing things. So as you know, my earlier months, whenever I was on nothing and I cold turkey, no TRT, whenever your hormones are in the gutter, I could do anything. 3 hours, 4 hours of cardio, I could drive myself on the ground with no calories and I would gain fat. Like, it's so amazing when you have everything imbalanced and working together that really things start to gel and kind of cool things happen. So it's interesting, but I will overfeed tonight. You guys will see what I'm doing tonight. I don't know. Rachel, it's her choice. She's the boss. Like I said, I'm happy doing sushi every weekend. Love sushi, typical bodybuilder. It's healthy, but it's an acquired taste and I love it. She gets sick of it, so I'm sure she wants to have something junky like pizza or whatever. And I'm game because I'm in decent enough shape now where I can handle that stuff. So we're gonna bring you guys along for that later. Cheat meal Saturday. It's Saturday, and me and Rachel were going back and forth. We were like, okay, maybe we should cheat on Sunday for Super Bowl Sunday, and we'll just have like a protein fat meal tonight out to dinner, something mild, and give it all we got for wings and pizza and beer tomorrow. Then we're like, you know what? We aren't even like diehard Patriots or Falcons fans, so maybe we're just gonna just go all out tonight.
Wings and pizza.
Mm-hmm. Why don't you show the viewers that, you know, you're the.
Oh yeah, I already got it started.
I would have been a little bummed too if we didn't cheat tonight because I worked out twice, thinking that we were. So
that's true. So we're gonna go to Wingstop because I don't know how great it is, but I know that our friend Carly and her husband Eric in Portland always talked about how great Wingstop was until we took them to Fire on the Mountain in Portland, which we love. But
hold on. Did they say Fire on the Mountain's better than Wingstop, though?
Well, they haven't had Wingstop in so long that I don't know. But Fire on the Mountain is, like, epic. Yeah. It's just so good. So
We're going to bring you guys along to multiple places tonight as we bounce around to get our cheat on.
That's true. I'm thinking about grabbing another drink for the next ride.
I need a cheat too because I'm feeling extra flat.
So. Okay. Let's go.
All right, guys. So we got our choices here. Bone-in or boneless. We're going to go primarily bone-in. Keep it OG and original. And we aren't going to mess with that atomic, which is five. Appetizer. All right, Rachel, we have the little boxes of all the flavors right now. We got the Parmesan. We got the...
That's the dry rub. That's definitely not dry rub.
That's juicy. That looks spicy.
I think mild.
Mild? Which is the boneless on the right?
Yeah.
And then we got honey mustard and ranch. And...
No, just ranch. Go ask her for honey mustard.
Oh, okay. There you guys go. Now next stop is pizza.
Round one accomplished. Wings are done for. Review. On a scale from like 1 to 10, don't worry, there's no one around us. Probably say what, a 5 or 6? 3? Rachel says 3. I'll show you why. So, very, very oily. And I get enough fat, obviously, without our regular diet throughout the week that we're kind of like fed up with oil. We want more protein, but it wasn't awful. But I would honestly say not a 3, but about like a 5. So we're on to pizza now. Round 2. All right, well, apparently we're not where we're supposed to be. We're at New York, New York, and there's delicious cheesecake, pizza, and there's an arcade behind me that looks pretty damn fun for a Saturday night. But we got to find the exact pizza place that Rachel's been talking about for like 4 years now since I did the USA's. And we're going to travel down the escalator and find it. But you know what? We'll put the wings behind us. I think there's a lot of good places here that I'm going to fulfill some of my my cravings for. So we'll just have to see. And we can play the arcade. I can whoop your ass at air hockey. And we might even look at that hotel app and maybe be spontaneous and stay at a hotel tonight. Fuck Smokey. Just joking, Smokey.
Found my pretzel. Been craving one for like 5 months.
Cinnamon sugar.
$6 cinnamon sugar pretzel. Now we're inside the Hershey store. No, not because I'm going to eat a bunch of junk, guys. It's just because Rachel's grandma loves this store, and we're going to send her a nice little gift. But check this out. Where is it? Oh, damn. 5 pound. That's like a Furious Pete challenge. I'm sure he's already done that. Thank you for the pretzel. All right. Well, maybe we might get a snack here, and if we do, we'll see what I get here. It's pretty cool. Oh, my God. Look at those Hershey syrup bottles. Those surely got to be empty, maybe? Yeah, they're empty. Wow. Look how money this is, guys. Heath coffee bits. Always been a Heath bar and a Score bar coffee fan. And then got, you know, Reese's peanut butter. All natural. Good for the keto diet. Clearly not. Hydrogenated quite through the roof. Yep. Looks good though, that damn orange label. It's enticing. Sugar-free cute stuff that I don't embark on anymore. Store's crazy.
Hey, Hershey Chocolate World guests. Our store is now closed.
Oh.
We thank you for shopping at Hershey Chocolate World and hope to see you again. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Damn. Treats galore. The right place. And it's still popping past midnight. pizza's the bomb. We had it after the USA's. I don't think we're gonna get a whole pie though. I think we're just gonna get a slice. I might get some more food while I'm here. I don't wanna be like a glutton and feel terrible. Alright, so I'm just gonna stick with a slice of pizza. Rachel's getting a slice. Because each slice is like $6. And then a whole pie is $25. And I knew if I got the whole pie, I'd feel like miserable shit. I was gonna have this and then maybe snack on some more stuff. So my plan is to add one slice to the other place. And this other place is still open. I'm gonna sample another slice at a new restaurant. Round 3. Rachel, she cashed out. All right, let's sample this slice and see what it's all about. Let's see how this compares to the other place downstairs. All right, second pizza place in New York, New York. Spinach. We're gonna see if it's any different than the other place. Obviously, the flavor's different. Crust is better. The last crust was a little bit more white and doughy. I got a blondie too. Little brownie. And we're gonna go home.
It's 1:40 a.m. Just got home. I'm gonna screw with some more stuff before I go to bed. Got this Halo Top ice cream oatmeal cookie. Hasn't been open. If you guys haven't heard of Halo Top, it's actually kind of healthy. It's a 2 grams of fat, high protein, 6 grams. Whole thing has 24 grams of protein. I have that. I have this Greek yogurt, high protein ice cream bar. There's this interesting cookie dough, super infused protein cookie dough spread that's frozen because I know if it's not frozen, I could dig into it. So it's like rock solid. I don't think I'm gonna be able to thaw that out, but I believe it's also infused with protein if you can focus in. Anyway, it has 5 grams of protein and fat. It's kind of like a nut butter. So it's like a edible cookie dough. So I'll probably mess with this, have a couple bars, give Smokey some ice cream, and then conclude this cheat session. So just to recap, it was 2 slices of pizza, disgustingly greasy wings, a blondie, and then now some of this crap. So nothing too crazy, but hopefully I'll fill out. Probably put on some glycogen. There we go.
I can't stop. Busted out the muffins that's been taunting me in the freezer. Just some healthy Trader Joe's muffins, but been sick of looking at them. So I'm gonna eat a muffin or two. Whew. That bran muffin, keep me regular. Killed the Halo Top. Killed the other Halo Top. I will take 3 metformins, 1500 milligrams before bed. I used to always do this whenever I did the natural hormonal enhancement diet back in like 2007, where you refeed actually twice a week. You do a carbohydrate overload. Of course, it's low fat, but I would do metformin before my meal towards the evening and then before bed. And then I'd wake up, I don't want to say in a ketogenic state because it wasn't a full ketosis because I was carb up twice a week during that diet, but I would be in a very low insulin, low blood sugar environment, and I'd feel pretty stable the next morning. So therefore, I'm going to take 1500 milligrams of metformin after all this damn carbs that I've been consuming tonight. So off onto the muffins.
Down lower.
Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
just in time for the Super Bowl, we decided that we were going to stop after the gym by Whole Foods and get a little something, but we ended up with a lot. Matt said he didn't want me to buy guacamole because we had enough avocados, so I bought a little more avocados. Cilantro.
One by one. We got some pepperoni.
That's cilantro.
Keto, MPA keto approved. Eden pumpkin seeds are delicious.
I don't know why you got these thin cut
these,
cheese.
You know why I got these? Because they're grass fed and they're individualized, so I can crunch numbers for my viewers if I have cheese. I don't have to weigh it. It's boom. The nutrition fact's already there.
And smoky, not for you.
Buffalo.
Blazing buffalo. That's hot, spicy.
Is that shit grass fed?
No. I don't really care.
It's top notch, though.
This is the Belton Farms Oak Smoked Cheddar. I've been getting this a lot just to put a little bit, like maybe 2 ounces, on my omelets or eggs in the morning. But
Smokey's watching your presentation.
He ate all of it, even though he said he was only going to eat like raw and all that crap. But Matt's been eating mine.
Grass-fed raw grass-fed.
He bought broccoli. Frozen broccoli.
I ran out of vegetables. I gotta be buttery stir fry my broccoli.
I am a huge fan of ranch.
Yeah, but is there soybean oil in there? What kind of oil's in there?
Who cares?
Soybean? You're not gonna shut off. Probably canola. Brie, or what is that?
No, organic sunflower oil.
Sunflower's so high polyunsaturated.
Yeah.
It's a no-no for inflammation.
A little bit of broccoli.
Oh, you got broccoli? I got broccoli. Jeez. All right. Mine's gonna be all buttery and deliciously stir-fried. That's an amazing dressing. That's amazing, guys. Greek with feta, black olive, sugar-free, chunks of feta in there. Focus. Zero carbs, which is probably kind of a lie. 15 grams of fat, but the good thing is olive oil, not bullshit cottonseed or sunflower or soy. So boom, that's not cheap and it's delicious though.
Celery.
Lemons, of course, for pH balance, alkalinity.
These are great for making burgers.
Butter lettuce.
A little bit more. Spicy pumpkin seeds.
Spicy version instead of the plain.
The
delicious.
The avocado, the jalapeno, one tomato, small tomato. Of course, these delicious Parmesan crisps.
Super Bowl.
I can go easy on them, but Matt just
Super Bowl approved.
Accidentally. These are kind of cool flax crackers that I found.
Yep, they're pretty much all fiber.
8 grams of carbs, but 7 grams of fiber.
1 gram net. Don't go overboard on those though.
Those are going to be my chips for Super Bowl.
Raw macadamia nuts, $1 million a pound.
And just an avocado and an onion.
There you go, $130. Boom, Whole Foods, love you. All right, and Super Bowl.
Time.
Let's go Falcons.
And Smokey, no more food.
Smokey enjoyed your presentation.
Maybe.